Hello, all around the freehold, all around the freehold. Hey, I just wanna know, baby, if I hit your phone, is you picking up, baby? Tell me what you want.
What's happening, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Today we are out here looking a tad bit rough. We just got back from our brief hiatus overseas. And we are safe and sound back at the crib. So today we're going to be breaking down this week's sneaker releases and agendas. I apologize. We took a week off. You know, we want to start off the new year with a calm little break. We've been uploading almost every day or every other day, more or less, this entire year with some great content. So I hope you guys have been enjoying it. If you guys have, please make sure to subscribe button, hit the like button, and all other shenanigans. And let me know in the comments below if you are ready for this week, because I certainly am. We got a lot of good ones. It's starting to heat up. You know, January was kind of slow to start off. 2021 was very, very slow. A lot of brick releases, a lot of releases that didn't go as planned, but it's starting to shape up to be pretty decent. This week, we got a few high-tier collaborations, some bricks, a good variety of both. So without further ado, let's get right into it. And we're up on the screen and looking right off the bat. We got some crazy special SBs, which are going to be the Street Hawkers. This is basically just NikeSneakers.com. This is what we're going to be using for the variety of this video in terms of what's going to be exactly going down this week. There's some other low-key sneakers as well, but it's like the good stuff that everyone is mainly interested in. So this is what we're going to go by. And as you can see, some stuff got delayed, like the Ray Guns. And I got some questions. Are the Taupe Haze Jordan 4s being delayed? Right now, it's up in the air. I know back doors wide open at retailers forum, so that's once again still up in the air. We'll have some more info on that shortly. Of course, on Instagram, make sure you follow us at tommyboy.tv. That's where you post a lot of news and information regarding sneaker releases via an Instagram format. And then make sure you guys check out the free app raffle. This app of sorts, you add it to your desktop, your home screen, whatever you want to do, or you can only just do it on the website. Create an account, doesn't take long at all, just your email, and you shows you every single raffle going on from every single retailer for every single release. So make sure you check it out. It gives you a release calendar. We may be soon adding a site list to it as well, so make sure you keep an eye out on it. Without a doubt, let's get right into it. So first up, we are going to go on to Notre.com, because this is like the main release, I would say, of this week, just because the fact is it's a very high tier collaboration. It's one similar to that of Bodega, Stussy, and that type of one, where they have a really, really good bot protection on Shopify, and typically there's a good amount of healthy stock online, so a lot of manual users cook, some bot users cook as well, as long as they've got the proper setup. But yeah, this is going to be the moon. This is going to be a movie for the week. This is the main item to focus on. If you're going to go for anything, this is one without a doubt you should be going for. One, it looks beautiful. Two, it goes for an insane amount of breesh. And three, two different colorways. I mean, you can't go, and this is like first time, like Nike really doesn't play around with messing up their swoosh, and they did it on this shoe. We'll have a full breakdown of this release and my tips and tricks on copying on Shopify sites like this tomorrow, so make sure you check out that video. That'll be dropping probably around 6 p.m. Eastern as always. Now, this is the Orwood Brown colorway exclusively dropping on Notre. You guys can see prices are very, very high, extremely high, over $1,000. Bids are somewhere not even close to that. They're around like $500, $600, maybe even less than that. As you can see, this 11.5 is lower. Without a doubt, it's going to be very much so worth the cop, no doubt about it. Definitely go all out on this release if you possibly can. Then we go on to the also mighty Nike SB Dunk Low Pro Street Hawkers, jumping from retail of $110. Now, today is the day that exclusive access event went out, which is Monday. And, few homies cooked. Some homies even caught base sizes, a 4.5. I know two members got coincidentally the same size in a 4.5, which is extremely, extremely rare in SBs, and they cooked them today on the app. And it was somewhat successful. I unfortunately didn't get exclusive access. We got exclusive access on something else, which we'll break down in a moment. But this shoe is 100% worth the buy, worth the investment as well. If you have access to a special box, definitely buy that up. Although I do gotta mention, if you're gonna invest in apparel, I'd more so focus on regular GR boxes. At the end of the day, special boxes are more like for collectors, and the demand is there at the beginning, but as time goes on, special box kind of just fades away. Like, everyone's like, I just rather have the shoe than a cardboard box that is a little bit special. But of course, it varies per person. Without a doubt, this is worth the buy. Skate shops dropped this past week, and if you guys didn't check out the How to Cop Guide, you missed out information on that one. So for future reference, make sure you tune in for the How to Cop Guides. As you can see, market did drop exactly how I predicted, around the $600 range. I see dropping even a bit more, especially bigger sizes. It looks like they're going down fast. I might have to pull 11.5 is the lowest. Wow. It's crazy because every SB has a different market. I know this is more based around the Chinese culture, so smaller sizes are obviously going to do better because that's the whole size range that they'll be wearing overseas is smaller sizes or smaller people. And it looks like 11.5 is the cheapest size, which is very, very rare to happen. That's my personal size. So, yo, we might have to pull the trigger on that, but I'm going to wait out on it just a few more days. And this is the other event, I mean, the other item that came out today, the exclusive access, which was the Icons book novel by Virgil Abloh and Nike. This is like a whole recap of like the prototypes, the work, the 10, and all the original artwork that did go into creating the first iteration of Nike and Off-White collaborations. Because if you didn't know, the 20 is coming out, which is going to feature Dunks, the Chicago Air Force One, which is the yellow and black sole. We got some weird dunk sock looking things. We got a lot of weird stuff coming out, but it's fire. Don't get me wrong. And it's going to be very, very profitable. So, of course, we'll have info on that throughout this year. And as for resale market on this novel, though, it's aight. Nothing too exceptional. It's around $90 to $100. Local sales, I don't even know what to tell you because locally, I don't know who the hell fucking wants this thing. I bought it just because it's dope in it. I just wanted a piece. I know I couldn't touch a lot of Off-White Nikes. At least I touched the book and at least I got something from them. And it's, I feel like it might appreciate over time, no doubt, because Virgil and Nike are cemented into sneaker history right now and for always. But retail, once again, is $70. I copped it. I mean, it's going to be a wide, wide release. There are going to be pre-orders available at bookstores, so it's not going to sell too rapidly. So if you're trying to resell it and go crazy for it, wouldn't really put too much time and effort into it. Then we got the Women's Air Jordan 4 Starfish retailing for $200, dropping this 22nd. I think that is going to have to be this Saturday at 10 a.m. Eastern. You guys can see the SKU code is right over here. As always, if you ever want to know more info about a shoe, you can always look up the SKU code into Google, or you can just head over to the app, and once again, it tells you a lot of good info about the shoe. Now, it is women's sizing. However, it is a Jordan 4. If you didn't know, Jordan 4s have been skyrocketing in demand, in hype, and in resale of value. People didn't listen. Fire Red Force, great hold, and look at them mooning right now. The GS size is going stupid. Of course, Time Out TV Plus members need to buy those up early. Now, as for also, I didn't want to mention the premium group. We are emailing people today and tomorrow. So if you guys didn't fill out the form, the waiting list form, we are emailing. We had the most amount of entries we've ever had for a form like this. So it's taken us a bit longer than we were expecting, so I do apologize for that. But today and tomorrow, I'll be sending out emails for information on how to purchase. So make sure you keep your eye out on your inbox if you did fill that out. Now, as for the resale market, listen, it's a one-man size, so I definitely focus either on super, super big sizes or super, super small sizes. Mid-range is all right, like a size 7 through 9. That's like the range I kind of stick away from. The rest of them are kind of safe-ish cups if you pay no tax, no shipping, and if you want to build up points. Other than that, though, I mean, I would save up your money for other future leases because, listen, it's getting no slow start, but that doesn't mean panic and go crazy and spend all your capital if you're low on it. Save it up. Taupe Haze 4s. We got UNC 1s. We got Shadow 1s. The Toes. We got 12s coming up. We got 30. We got like quick brick flips, and this is like one of those as well. But once again, if you don't got a lot of capital and you can't invest in it too crazy, then I wouldn't bother with them. But long term wise, these could end up being some good profit. Moving on to the Air Max 1 LV8 Obsidians, retailing for $150. And by the way, those fours, I see them probably dropping to around the $230, $220 range in most sizes, bigger sizes. Once again, I see holding them around $250, $260 and going up. If you can hop anywhere from 11W to 12W, great hold in my opinion. Then we go on to the Air Max 1s. As I mentioned, the Obsidian colorway. Once again, Air Max GR, like the neutral, like basic ass colors are coming out to be more of a regular thing, like at least one colorway every single month, or at least every single month, I should say. Sometimes they come out even a bit more frequently than that. But as for the resale market of this specific colorway, it's going to be the same as we saw for the Aurora Greens and the Magma Oranges. They pretty much stick around 230, 200, 200, 230 before release. And once they come out on sneakers, they drop down to like 180, 190. And they stay around there. They don't have much volatility after that. Once again, Air Maxes I see becoming more of a demanded product as time goes on. But it's going to take a few years. And pretty much basic colorways aren't the main focus by most people. Everyone does love those high tier collaborations. Then we go on to, once again, the Dunk High Notre, which is going to be the Midnight Navy colorway. Now, this is the colorway dropping exclusively on sneakers, not exclusively, as well as on other sites. Notre is going to have them, as well as a few other, possibly other retailers. But as for the time being, it looks like just Nike and Notre are going to have these two sneakers because it's a collaboration with the boutique. And just like what happened with Bodega, it only happened between Nike and Bodega. What happened with Stussy, the black pair did get a wide release. But that's going to be different. Stussy is carried by other brands. Simply Notre doesn't have their products carried by other brands. Therefore, it's going to be just Nike and Notre. Go all out for it. Bought Nike up because that's a thing now. Unfortunately, it is what it is. You can't hate on them because that's just Nike's fault. They're not really filtering out accounts and bot entries. But this one is looking a bit more less demanded. The market is looking a bit lower. This is because the fact is, once again, it's going to be on sneakers and Notre. So it's looking to be a little bit of a wider stock. Then we go on to the Air Jordan 5 Low Chinese New Year, retailing for $215, dropping the 23rd. My mistake, the Starfishes should be dropping this Friday. These CNYs should be dropping this Saturday at 10 a.m. Eastern. And I think they're absolutely disgusting and horrid and a disgrace. I hate Jordan 5 Lows, period. I hate all Jordan Retro Low cuts besides like ones, all right. But everything else, disgusting, should never be a thing. But that's just my opinion out here. It's an all-time classic. The Jordan 5 High is, at least. But these Lows, I just reminds me of high school and not it. Definitely not it. $215 retail is very, very expensive. But the reason being, it does wear a tear away. So you can see the colorway behind this. This fabric, I should say, does tear away and into that. You can actually see it. It's almost like see-through. It does tear away to this, and it's actually looking too much for me. Way too much for me. And resale market of things, though, is looking somewhat decent, I guess. I'm going to put this more into the brick category for this week, just because the fact is, market's already down to 220, 230, and I just wouldn't go too crazy on bigger sizes or a safer bet. Clearly, pre-selling these is a best bet, but I could see these possibly going up as time goes on, just because that's what happens to most Chinese New Year Nike products. But definitely not a safe investment. You definitely have better stuff to put your money into. That's without a doubt. Then we go to the Yeezy 700 Sun. This shoe is going to be limited. We're selling for $240, which is more expensive than we've seen a 700 drop at a retail price of. Interested to see that they're raising retail on them. And is it worth the buy? Actually, they're supposed to be even a bit higher than that. I'm pretty sure they're supposed to be 260 and they dropped them back down to 240. It was like a mixed washy thing. And I'm looking at them right now and this is just like, I would never put this shit on my feet. But every 700 does go up. Like every 700 and always ends up being very, very limited. People look at the colorway, specifically this one. And I'm like, why? Why are we doing this right now in winter? At least drop it in spring or summer. But it looks like literally a flame coming up onto it. I'm not the biggest fan of the shoe, but will I be buying them? Absolutely. I think they'll be doing great, great numbers. I might have a separate guide on these as well, just because I've been getting a lot of questions. And I think people might disagree with my opinion, but I do see these being worth the buy at retail. In terms of investing in them, possibly. I'll make a separate video once I dive more into the 700 market, because honestly, I haven't looked at 700s in a minute. All I know is that every single 700 that I sold early goes up, and that's almost every single time. So I learned my lesson. I started holding it more 700s, and it kind of does pay off. So this is just one of them I'm just going to end up holding for the long term. Why? 700s don't really restock. They're a really in-demand product, and they don't drop a lot of colors in them either. So that's about a wrap on this week. I know there's going to be a few more other products dropping this week, but this is just the main core ones. And of course, subscribe to the channel. Hit the thumbs up button if you guys want to be notified, and hit the notification bell as well if you want to be notified when I drop the rest of the How to Cop guides this week. Now, thank you guys for tuning in with me, sticking with my scaly looking face, and I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.